I would like to take this video as an opportunity to show you how virtual machines can make testing unknown software safer, trying out new operating systems much easier, and running old software possible at all. Let's look at different ways to run virtual machines and where to get installation files for virtual operating systems. If you don't know, a virtual machine is an emulation of a computer system inside your actual computer. This makes it possible to run Linux or macOS in a window inside your current Windows installation, or even run multiple Windows installations side by side. These virtual machines are separate from the host operating system by default, so you cannot damage or screw up your host computer from inside the virtual machine. If your PC is running Windows 10 Pro, Enterprise or Education, you can actually try this out right now. These Windows 10 editions come with a sandbox to test suspicious software before running it on the host system. Other Windows editions can use different methods, shown later in the video. You might have to enable the sandbox first by hitting Windows key plus R to open the run window and typing in optional features. Then search for Windows Sandbox, select it and click OK. If you now search for Sandbox, Windows will open the temporary Windows system for testing. All changes inside the sandbox will disappear when you close it. You can copy-paste files inside of it to try them out. If you need a more permanent machine, for example for trying out other operating systems, you can also use Microsoft Hyper-V, which is also only available on Windows 10 Pro and up. You might have to enable it in the same way as the sandbox feature, but instead of sandbox, look for Hyper-V, then restart your PC. Search for Hyper-V Quick Create to create a virtual machine. Hyper-V can only create a limited number of operating systems, including Windows 10 machines, Ubuntu and some other Linux systems. Unless you want to install Windows 10 Developer or Ubuntu, you will need an ISO installation file for the operating system. You can download ISO files for the latest Windows 10 release directly from the Microsoft website. Or if you want to install Debian, for example, visit their website and find the ISO download. Otherwise, Hyper-V will download them for you automatically. If you're using a Linux image, deselect the Secure Boot option. When finished, connect to the virtual machine and you will see the usual Windows installation screen. After installation, you can use your virtual machine however you like, although in the long run you will probably need a separate Windows license for this separate machine. Just like on your host system, you can run software and browse the web, but with added security for your host system. It also depends on the hardware of your host system, how well the virtual machine runs, and if you can even play simple games. At any time, it's possible to create checkpoints of the virtual Windows machine, which you can then later return to. To create a new checkpoint, right-click on the machine in Hyper-V Manager and click Checkpoint. The new checkpoint will appear below. To return to a checkpoint, right-click the checkpoint and click Apply. If you can't or don't want to use Hyper-V, two other free options are Oracle VirtualBox and VMWare Workstation Player. Both can pretty much run any guest operating system, including old Windows versions. You will have to supply the ISO file yourself. I'll show you the basic workflow in VirtualBox, but it works very similar in Workstation Player. Click on New to create a new virtual machine. After specifying a name and the location, choose the operating system to install. Select the amount of memory to allocate to the virtual machine, then create the virtual hard disk and choose the size. When you first launch the virtual machine, select the ISO file you have downloaded for this operating system. Then VirtualBox will start the installation process. You might have to remove the ISO file from the virtual machine after the installation, otherwise it might boot from the ISO instead of the virtual hard drive. this isn't supposed to be a comprehensive guide for VirtualBox, just be aware that there are many settings for each virtual machine to extend its capability. I also recommend to install the VirtualBox extension pack for better support in Windows virtual machines. VirtualBox can also create snapshots just like the checkpoints in Hyper-V. To create a new snapshot, while a virtual machine is running, click on Machine, then Take Snapshot. To revert to a snapshot, while the machine is off, switch from the Details view to Snapshots. Right-click the snapshot and select Restore. These tips should get you started in the world of virtual machines. And if you need some more ideas, let's say for a high security system, some people install Linux as their host operating system, then use different Windows virtual machines to separate web browsing and working, or you could even create a dual boot system on your host with a Windows installation only for gaming. I hope this was helpful. See you next time.